हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मयूर खेरीमठ, वर्किंग एज ए लेक्चरर इन ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मोतीचंद लिंगरे भरतेज पॉलिटेक्निक बेलगामी। एट द आउटसेट आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस माय हार्टफेल्ट ग्रेटिट्यूड टू द एंटायर एलएमएस टीम फॉर गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कंडक्ट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। नाउ कमिंग बैक टू माय जॉब व्हिच इज असाइंड टू मी इज आई एम गोइंग टू take few sessions from unit 1 of energy resource and alternative fuels subject, which is an elective subject which is very very essential and which is very very interesting, as well as which is also having a lot of vacuum in the market nowadays. This technology is gaining more and more importance in the market. Coming to the title of the unit, one is energy conservation and storage. Here basically we are dealing with what is the principle of energy conservation, what is the energy storage, different classification of energy sources, as well as energy storage techniques. So after completing the first unit, the course outcome designed to achieve is student should be able to discuss the need of energy conservation and various methods of energy storage. The syllabus of first unit is shown in contents. That is, basically we are dealing with energy sources, their availability, then mainly the importance of renewable energy resources, principle of energy conservation, need and different methods of energy storage techniques. Coming to the first heading of the unit, that is energy sources and their availability. So before going with the syllabi, we'll try to recall the definition of energy. Energy is nothing but it is the strength and the vitality which is sustained for physical or mental activity. So every country draws its energy from variety of sources. The variety of sources are broadly categorized into two main types. One is commercial and another one is non-commercial. Examples of commercial sources include the usage of fossil fuels, hydroelectric power and nuclear power, while non-conventional energy sources include wood, animal waste and agricultural wastes. So in a fully industrialized country like USA, energy requirements are met most of the times from commercial sources only, while in a developing nations like India or less developed country like India, the usage of commercial as well as non-commercial energy resources are equal. How do we classify the energy sources? The energy sources are mainly classified into five different headings. The first one is based on usability of energy. The second one is based on traditional use. The third one is based on long-term availability. Fourth one is based on commercial application. And the fifth one is based on origin. Based on usability of energy, again, we can have two different types, like primary resources and secondary resources. Primary resources are, if you want to know the definition of primary resources, it is very simple. Resources which are available in the nature, however some sorts of processing or some sorts of transformations are required, such resources are called as primary resources. Say for example, coal, crude oil, sunlight, wind, natural vegetation, radioactive material, all exists in the nature, but we can't use them directly. In order to use, we have to transform them from their basic origin. Coming to the secondary resources, the definition of secondary resources is the energy resources supplied directly to the consumer or to the end user by one or more transformation. Such resources are called as secondary resources. Example, electrical energy, thermal energy, refined fuels or synthetic fuels such as hydrogen fuels. So they are made to available to consumer directly by some sort of processing, again say more than one step. So that's about the first classification based on usability of energy. There may be primary resources as well as secondary resources. Coming to the second heading, that is based on traditional use, here we can have again two types: conventional energy sources or non-conventional energy sources. Conventional energy sources, it might be defined like this: the energy resources which are used for many decades, even at the time of oil crisis of 1973, those resources are known as what? Conventional energy resources. Say for example, fossil fuels, nuclear and hydro resources all fall under conventional energy resources. The non-conventional energy resources can be understood like this: the energy resources which were designed to use at a larger scale after the oil crisis of 1973, those resources are known as non-conventional energy resources. For example, solar energy, wind energy, biomass energy, geothermal energy, like that n number of non-conventional energy sources are coming into the market. So after the oil crisis of 1973, that is when the Arab countries banned the exporting of the petroleum products, at that time the country started to go with other sorts of technology which can be used, where the non-conventional energy sources can be used. So after the oil crisis of 1973, non-conventional energy sources development took in a very rapid pace. So that's about, based on traditional use, we can have two types: one is conventional and another one is non-conventional. Now, based on long-term availability, the energy resources may be non-renewable or renewable. Non-renewable energy sources are those which are finite. That means they are going to exit from the this atmosphere when it is used at a greater and greater extent. Say for example, fossil fuel, uranium, all falls under non-renewable energy resources. They can't be reproduced. The second one is renewable energy resources. The energy sources which are finite, which are available abundantly in nature, are known as renewable energy sources. Say for example, wind power, solar power, geothermal, tidal and hydroelectric power, all are renewable energy sources. So that's about the third classification based on long-term availability: non-renewable energy sources and renewable energy sources. So nowadays, if you see any of the automobile sector, the emission norms are becoming more and more stringent. So even some of the competitive automobile manufacturers are going with electric vehicle technology, some are going with hybrid vehicle technology, because the non-renewable energy sources are posing lot of problem on this Earth's atmosphere. When we are burning the conventional fossil fuel like petrol or diesel, there is a release of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxides of nitrogen, as well as unburnt hydrocarbon. All these gases are depleting the ozone layer day by day. So there is a very urgency to reduce the usage of fossil fuels. So that's why nowadays the electric vehicles are coming into the market, where in electric vehicle again we can use hydrogen as a fuel, which is a renewable, or we can run the vehicle on the battery operated technology, that is known as battery operated electric vehicle, simply recharging the car battery just like your mobile charging. Similar technology is coming into the cars also. So mainly to reduce the pollution, to develop the eco-friendly or environmental friendly vehicles. Basically all of the renewable energy sources are there now, they are very environmental friendly, so they are polluting the atmosphere at a very minimum level. Fourth classification is based on commercial application. Under this we can have two types, that is commercial energy resource and the other one is non-commercial energy resource. Resources which are available in the market for a certain price are known as commercial energy resource. Say for example electricity, coal, refined petroleum products, all are coming under the commercial energy resource. Then what are non-commercial energy resources? Energy resources which are available in the market without any price tag mentioned on them are known as non-commercial energy resources. Say for example solar energy for water heating, animal mode of transportation, irrigation, sugarcane crushing, agro waste, firewood in rural areas, all fall under non-commercial energy resource. So most of the times the non-conventional energy resources are neglected in energy accounting. Often it is ignored. Then the last classification is based on the origin, how the energy originated. Say for example, directly I have given the example fossil fuels energy, the chain of hydrocarbon, and nuclear energy, that is hydro energy, solar, wind, biomass energy, geothermal energy, tidal energy, ocean thermal energy, like different forms of energy are also available based on their origin. So in this subject basically topics are studied, like solar energy, wind energy, then the focus is given to alternative fuels, that is secondary. Few energy technology will be studied in energy resources and alternative fuels subject. So that's all about classification of energy sources. Five types of classifications are there. I explained all of them, and even I have given the definitions as well as examples. So to assess the level of understanding in today's session, we'll go with multiple choice questions test, where I have framed a few MCQs and four options are given for each of them. So I am going to give around 20 to 30 seconds of time. Just read the question and mark the correct response, and at the end you can assess by yourself whether you went with correct option or wrong option. So the first question is, dash is the example of primary resources. So recall the definition of primary resources, then easily you can select the correct answer. primary resources which are easily available in the nature, some sorts of transformations are required, are known as what? Primary resources. So the options here given are coal, electrical energy, thermal energy and synthetic fuels. So electrical energy, thermal energy, synthetic fuels are the wrong answers. So the correct answer is coal, because coal exists in nature and it is mined and it is used later. So the right answer is coal. Second question is, dash is the example of secondary resources. Recall the definition of secondary resources, where the resources are made available to user directly by one or more steps of transformation or processing. Options given are A. rivers, B. crude oils, C. electrical energy and D. all of these. Just think over it, recall the definition and select the appropriate response. Later we can discuss. So here the right answer is electrical energy. I'm confident that you people know how the electrical energy is generated. It is not directly taken from the market, right? Somewhere the coal is extracted, next it is burnt and then steam is produced, and somewhere the turbine is made to rotate, then only the electricity can be generated. Or if you go with the hydroelectric power, it is also very similar, where the water is made to allow flow from higher head to lower head, and one turbine is kept at the lower head and it is made to rotate. So it is an example of secondary resources. The right option is C, that is electrical energy. Now coming to the third question, that is example of renewable energy sources. So here the option given are, you can see option A, wind energy, option B, solar energy, option C, geothermal energy and option D, all of these. Try to recall the definition of renewable energy sources. The sources which are finite, the sources which are infinite, which are available abundantly in the nature, are known as renewable energy sources. I forgot to mention one of the important feature of this renewable energy resource. Renewable energy resource can be harnessed without polluting the atmosphere. That is also one special feature of this renewable energy resources. Just think over with all the options given: wind energy, solar energy, geothermal energy and all of these. So the right answer is option D, that is all of these. Wind energy, that means here the wind velocity is used to generate electricity. Solar energy means here the sun's radiation is used to produce what? To produce heat. Solar energy. And the third one is geothermal energy. Sometimes the useful energy can be extracted from earth crusts also. So that is also one example of renewable energy resources only. So the right answer is option D. All of these are renewable energy resources, that is wind, solar, geothermal. Not only three, even there are many renewable energy sources, like tidal is there, ocean thermal energy is there, like that n number of renewable energy sources are available. Now moving to next question, that is dash is the example of commercial energy resources. Please recall the definition of commercial energy resources. the resources which are available in the market for certain price. Some price tag is mentioned on them, then they are known as what? Commercial energy resources. Just go through the options given. A is sugarcane crushing, B is electricity, C is irrigation, and D is agro waste. Sugarcane crushing, irrigation, agro waste, all are the non-commercial energy resources. So the option left is electricity. Electricity is the commercial energy resource where to use it some sort of price has to be paid. That is the answer. Moving to the one more MCQ, that is fifth one. Dash is the example of non-commercial energy resources. The resources which are available for free or no price tag are mentioned on them are known as non-commercial energy resources. And the options given here are: A is solar energy for water heating, B is refined petroleum products, C is electricity, and D is all of these. Just think over, the petroleum products are not freely available in the market, electricity is also not freely available in the market. So the option left is, that is A, solar energy for water heating. So when the temperature of the sun is used to raise the temperature of water, that technology itself is available for free, that is solar energy for water heating. So that's all about today's class. To recall quickly, we discussed about two types of energy sources where the energy can be drawn, that is one is commercial and another one is non-commercial. And later we discussed about the classification of energy sources, like based on usability of energy, based on traditional use, based on long-term availability, based on commercial application, and based on origin. And also we have solved a few MCQs. So that's all about today's session. Or just I will show the correct answers once again. That is, for question 1, option A was the right, option A, and for question 2, the option C, and for question 3, option D, and for question 4, option B, and for question 5, option A. So the contents I have referred from the textbooks are shown in the references slide. Non-conventional energy sources by G.T. Rai, and non-conventional energy sources by B.H. Khan. Very standard textbooks or reference books. These are from these textbooks only I have prepared the contents. And once again I would like to thank the LMS team for providing me an all the support and guidance during the design of contents. So thank you very much, the entire LMS team. So see you all in the session 2. Thank you.